right now I'm walking through the woods, and I just left one of the most notorious prisoner of war camps in U.S. history, known as Andersonville. This is a place where 45,000 Union men were held, over 13,000 died, in some of the most disgusting, squalid conditions known to man. If you haven't watched that video, you can go back and check that out. Well, at its worst, Andersonville was seeing a death rate of about 100 soldiers a day. And after they died, they would be carried through these woods right here and buried in this field that I'm headed to. A lot of those men would be lost to history were it not for the efforts of a man who was imprisoned here by the name of Dorrance Atwater. Atwater kept a record of all of the dead as best as he could. And after the war, he and Clara Barton, who went on to found the American Red Cross, came back to this place and marked as many of the graves of the dead as they possibly could. And today, that place is right here at Andersonville National Cemetery. Here, as you're walking into Andersonville National Cemetery, where they have this somber-looking monument to those who died here. And then down at the bottom has a verse from Zechariah 9:12, says, "Turn you to the stronghold, ye prisoners of hope." Here's a picture of Dorrance Atwater, who was the ex-prisoner that I mentioned that kept records and came back with Clara Barton to help mark the graves. The graves were originally just marked with numbered stakes, but thanks to their efforts, we now know the names. And you can see, you know, most of them were just buried in trenches. So whenever we start looking at the markers, you'll see that they are very close together. And then here's an artist's depiction of the dead at Andersonville being buried. Here you can see just a few of the nearly 13,000 that are buried here at Andersonville. And again, the markers are so close together because all of these men were just buried in a trench, just nearly shoulder to shoulder. So men like Francis Custerman and Hall from New York, Hugh Robinson. These were all men who met their end right here at the Andersonville Civil War Prisoner of War Camp. Here we have a few more markers. Now this one is an unknown soldier. You can see, looks like somebody came here and left a marker to show that they visited. They weren't able to identify all of the Union soldiers that were buried here. So, of course, some of them are going to be marked unknown. You can see in some cases they were even able to include their rank, like Corporal William H. Napper from Indiana. I don't see any other rank just here within my eyesight. But man, what a job this must have been to come back and mark all of these graves. By the way, I also want to point out that if you see these clumps of grass here, don't be too harsh on the people that upkeep this cemetery. They're cutting the grass today, so we just happen to be here like in the midst of the grass cutting. Just kind of walking along, looking at these graves. One of the things that I read said that if a soldier had clothes that were even halfway decent, he was almost always buried nearly naked because they didn't get any new clothing in the camp, and clothes were literally just rotting off of people. So if somebody died and had a halfway decent pair of shoes or shirt or pants or anything like that, he was almost always stripped. And I guess some pretty violent fights broke out over some of the possessions of the dead. Unimaginable. There's this interesting and awful story that came out of Andersonville. Now, Andersonville was an enlisted man's prison camp, so there were no officers there. And with no leadership in the camp, man, it turned to anarchy pretty quick. And there was this one group that organized, and they called themselves the Raiders. And these were some truly awful people. They went around bullying the other camp members, in some cases resorted to murder, stole food, stole clothing, just really an awful bunch. Well, in response, another group organized, and they called themselves the Regulators. They basically rounded up all of these raiders, and with permission of the camp commandant, put them on trial. Some of them had to run the gauntlet, where you'd have these two lines of soldiers with clubs, and they would beat these offenders as they ran through. But there were six whose offenses were so terrible, and they were kind of the ringleaders of the bunch, that they were sentenced to hanging. And they are buried right here. So here are the graves of Patrick Delaney. I'm guessing that's Charles Curtis, William Collins. I don't know the first name there, but Sarsfield, Rickson, and Munn. So these guys were the Andersonville Raiders. And if you'll notice, their graves are right here together, but they are not buried with the other Union prisoners of war, because they were deemed unworthy to have an eternal place of rest next to these other men. So they lie here in a place of eternal dishonor. Wow. That is actually kind of a heavy thing to see. You know, every time I come to one of these cemeteries, I think about, you know, anybody who watches this or who is drawing breath has to think about that at some point along the line, we're all going to end up like these guys right here, 6 feet under. And you have to think about how you want to be remembered. You want to be remembered as an honorable person, somebody that lived for a higher purpose, lived for the good of others and the glory of God, or do you want to be remembered as somebody who is dishonorable, lived for themselves, took, stole, was selfish, greedy? I don't know. That's what places like Andersonville National Cemetery make me reflect on. Amazing place, if you ever have a chance. Come to this cemetery. It really is something else.